came here in 1975 as a teacher of chemistry. I've been headmaster for the last 22 years and plan to be here for a while more. My wife and I raised our three kids here and have made a wonderful life and career by being at Trinity Pauling. Trinity Pauling is 105 years old. It was founded in 1907 by Dr. Frederick Luther Gamage. And in many senses, we are still the same school that Dr. Gamage founded 105 years ago. He believed in a combination of intellectual work in the classroom, healthy exercise on the fields, and a sense of respect of others. We are an Episcopal school and have an Episcopal chapel, and we meet in the chapel regularly, although many of our students, in fact, probably the majority of our students, are not Episcopal. Many of them are not even Christian. We have Jews, we have Muslims, we have people of all faiths. What is important is that we use the chapel as a place of gathering for the school community. People ask me as I enter my fourth decade in education what the biggest change has been in my career. And I would say twofold. One, parental expectations. Parents are asking us to do things that they may have done themselves in generations before. But more importantly, it's probably technology. On the positive side, technology has been wonderful in the classroom. With smart boards in many of the classrooms, the teachers can do amazing things. One of the principles of Trinity Pauling is self-advocacy. I ask each boy to solve his own problems. Come to us to solve his problems. There's no point in calling mom in Turkey, for example, to say that the laundry didn't come in. The boy needs to go down to the laundry room and talk to the person down there. We need to teach boys to be self-reliant. In the bigger picture, our overall mission is to take boys, young men, and help them grow into young adults. And as we all know, that means a sense of responsibility. One of my messages to the boys when they arrive at Trinity Pauling for their freshman or sophomore years is to get involved. Take advantage of all the opportunity for things to happen. We have about 40 clubs, ranging from the Italian club, which had a dinner and a movie last night, pottery club, paintball club, skeet shooting club, all sorts of things that kids like to do, and boys in particular like to do things with their hands. One of my favorite stories is a boy who was here as a senior 2 years ago and thought that he should be a basketball star. And in the process of his time at Trinity Pauling, he learned that he was actually a better actor and a better singer than he was a basketball player. Why would I send my child to Trinity Pauling? We have a very dedicated faculty who spends time working with the boys in the classroom, on the sports field, and in the dormitory. The most important thing that differentiates Trinity Pauling from many other schools is our effort system. We rank every student by effort, 1 through 5, with 1 being excellent. In every area of school life, 5 or 6 academic classes, the dormitory, sports, citizenship, work program, activities. I may not be a good math student, or I may not be a good English student, or I may not be a good history student, but I want to be recognized for my effort. If there's one single factor that the boys tell me, and that I agree with the boys, is that we are a very strong community. When somebody makes a mistake, we help that person rectify the mistake. When someone speaks badly of another, or in a fit of anger isn't doing the right thing, we support that person and work through the difficult pieces of it. We are a very strong community. Trinity Pauling is a good place. We take care of young men. We recognize that they're works in progress. We recognize that they need to be, well, I don't want to use the word coddled because it's not exactly what we do, but we recognize they need to be supported and helped as they grow and learn to stand on their own 2 feet.
Dublin, 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 high school.